Have you ever wondered why optical connectors are spring-loaded? Of course, you should never touch the end face of a connector, but if you want to find out more, please stick around and we'll check it out. Okay, let's take a closer look to the principle of such an optical connector. Here on the left-hand side, you can see one of the base elements of such a connector. It's the so-called ferrule. The ferrule is made of zirconia. It's a ceramic-like material, which is very hard and which is machined extremely precisely. In the middle, there's a borehole where the fiber is inserted and attached by adhesive. And then as a final step, the end face is polished. Now, a base principle of such a connector is that both sides, so this means both fibers, are in contact. The surfaces have to be mated by force in the end, because if there is no physical contact, by the way, this is the acronym for PC polish, if there is no physical contact, then we would have a problem. If there's a gap, there can be insertion loss, we can have return loss, and we even can have interferences in your network, which can cause problems. How is this done? As mentioned before, it's done by a spring force, which forces the two connectors together. So now there's one problem. If we have such a transceiver, and inside the transceiver there's a ROSA module with a receptacle, and typically those receptacles, they are not spring-loaded. They have this ferrule, but they are fixed. So how can we make sure that there is no problem, that we don't have a gap there? It's quite easy. The convention says it's enough that at least one side of this optical connection is spring-loaded. And as all the connectors on cables are spring-loaded, we don't have a problem with the transceivers. Okay, now let's take a look at an actual connector. We cracked it open. So here you can see the housing with a latch to fix it in the connector. Here, this is the ferrule I mentioned before. And if we now go a little bit to the right, here you can see this is the spring which causes the force to mate the two connectors, the two ferrules. And on the right side, okay, there's a cap and a bend protection for the fiber. I hope you learned something today. If so, please leave a comment and see you in one of the next videos. Bye-bye.